historical cemetery, formerly a colonial cemetery, is intertwined with the history of the British naval landing on Hong Kong Island in 1841, witnessing the history of Hong Kong from the colonial era to the present day.
Our cemetery was established in 1845. Most of the people buried here are Westerner, or what we call the Guai Lo.
One Guai Lo, British diplomat, linguist and botanist Henry Fletcher Hance, died in 1866 and his grave was found in Hong Kong cemeteries. He had a lasting impact on the study of the flora of South China. Many plants' Latin names can be traced back to his discoveries, like Syzygium's Hance Myrrh and Piper Hance Nacine.
When they pass away, their relatives will return their home country. So not many of the relatives came to this to give the respect to their ancestors. And there is less disturbance to the cemetery.
Today, we can say that there are three parties that constantly contribute to the landscape: authorities, individuals, and nature. Authority. Judging from old maps, it was built as a symmetrical structures with crossroads of avenues extending from the center of a Victorian-style fountain. Trees were planted on both sides of the avenue in old days. Nestled in valleys, some trees are protected from extreme weather and human damage over centuries. They grew into towering trees and become Hong Kong's old and valuable trees. Among them, like Clateva unilocularis, Senna siamia, Swietenian mahogany, Litchi chinensis, and Cleistocalic nevosum. They standing tall at over 25 meters with diameter breast height DBH exceeding 800 millimeters.
Individuals. Some trees next to the gravestone were intentionally planted by descendants to provide companionship to their ancestors, reflecting the multicultural fabric of Hong Kong. Two Alexander palms were specifically chosen by someone to honor the memory of his wife and mother. The choice of two species, largely influenced by personal tastes, introduced an irregular diversity to the cemetery's botanical landscape. Cherry blossoms are found in Japanese grave area, a flower emblematic of Japan symbolizes the return of soul to their homeland in their culture.
Last, the nature. Natural factors like winds, wind, wild animals and birds also play a crucial role to the landscape. In particular, animals and birds could disperse tree seed in any corner, resulting in the quiet emergence and gradual growth of woody trees from graves and stone walls. These trees, in turn, interact with cemetery and environment in various ways. They must stand alongside tombstones and certain graves, pushing on them or even destroying them. The graves and trees become intertwined, exemplifying both the starkness and the vibrancy of nature. The hillside is dotted with stonewall pine tree, which provide habitat of a variety of wildlife and enhance the distinctive character of the cemetery.
The Hong Kong cemetery has a rich variety of plants with colors and rich cultural layers. Here, even in hot weather, the ground cover remains lush and cool. Bamboo also acts as a natural wall to block annoying sightlines. However, the cemetery fountains has been filled with soil and plants due to ease of maintenance, which might distract from the overall landscape design.
The historic cemeteries where Hans rests harbors more than just memories. This peaceful oasis, it is both a final resting place for the departed and a treasurable site for us.
In Hong Kong Cemetery, a paradise in stone, where life and death intertwine.